Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. You're watching the NM Lifestyle. Let's get started with this video.
Gonna get down.
So the first fact about leg days is it's really great and it gives you a lot of strength and it doesn't make you look like a person who just has the upper body and not the legs, because there are a lot of people who just train their upper body and not their legs. They look extremely idiotic. If you train your upper body, you should give equal importance to your lower body. I know it hurts, I know you get a lot of pain, but it's fine, it's for your own good, alright? The first fact being it has great effects on recovery. Now, leg has a lot of muscles like the thighs, the calves, the hamstrings. When you do the leg workouts, there are a lot of muscles which get into picture. There are a lot of muscles which get indulged in the leg workouts when you do squats and lunges. It adds up as a big thing for you. It needs more recovery and that's why you get a lot of pain after leg day. Let's take for an example that if your biceps aren't growing, your triceps aren't growing, maybe your chest doesn't show much gains and your back isn't really stronger. So all you need to do is just do one thing. All you need to do is do squats just before doing the weak muscle workout. As if you're training back today and if you feel that your back is weak, so start doing squats. Maybe 20 to 50, that's enough, but do squats. Because squats is considered as a compound movement. A compound movement has a lot of muscles added up to it. So it takes a lot of muscles to do just one rep of squats. So if you do 50 squats, you're using a lot of muscles right then, and that's why it will need more recovery. Your body will produce more HGH, that is human growth hormone, and that's really necessary to get proper recovery. And if you really want recovery, you should try this out. And the second fact being, if you are an athlete, if you're a person who runs a marathon or maybe you sprint, then it's really great for you to have nice toned legs, and it's really beneficial for you to train legs because your legs are the main part when it comes to running. Your legs will be warmed up when you keep training your legs day by day. When you put on really good gains in your legs, what actually happens is you get more of strength to push your body further, and that's when it adds up to being a better athlete. So if you're an athlete and if you are not training legs, then I don't know what you're doing. So please train legs and don't skip leg day. So the third fact being, when you do lunges and squats, you need to keep your back straight. What happens is that a lot of people have lower back pain. When they do this, they have great effect on their back and their lower back pain gets reduced with time. So if you are having lower back pain and you are not doing leg workouts, just start doing it and it will be really beneficial for you. And for hamstrings and for lower back problems, I suggest doing good mornings with lightweight, because good mornings are a great way to train your hamstring as well as your lower back. You can take that on a back day or maybe on a leg day, it's your choice, but it works on lower back as well as the hamstrings, so please do try it. And if you want to know what is good mornings, then I'll surely tell you. Just tell me in the comment section about it. So when you train legs, your muscles are growing. You tear your muscles and your muscles get repaired in the recovery phase. And what happens is that when you have nice legs, you look better with it. So a lot of people have skinny legs, a lot of people have fat legs. They have a lot of fat accumulated in their thighs. That doesn't make them look good. So if you're a guy who is a bit bulky, or if you're a girl who wants to lose weight from the thighs, train your legs twice a week and it will be a game changer for you. You will look better in your jeans, in your joggers, whatever you wear. It will look great for you and it will do wonders for you. If your legs are stronger, your core will be stronger. It adds up to your personality. The fact about having a stronger body. Now, a body means upper body and lower body together. When people just train upper body, they have kind of low self-confidence, and that's related with the mindset. Some people find it irrelevant, but I really feel that if you don't even train legs, then I feel that your confidence will be boosted by a certain amount of percentage. And if you train legs, there's a condition. If you train legs, if you train yourself regularly, even if you train once a week, it's fine, but you should train. You should never skip leg days, and it adds up to your confidence. If you have a nice body, you will be confident enough to speak to people. You'll have a nice mindset, and that's how you do it. And if you find this content informative, please do subscribe to the channel, share the video, share the knowledge, and thank you for watching this video, guys. I'll see you guys in the next video. Till then, stay fit, stay active, and don't skip leg days. Bye-bye.